Liverpool 3-0. Corner taken it quickly, Origi! Stays alive, Cristiano Ronaldo! Five minutes, Cristiano Ronaldo! Balotelli! Aguero!
Pass the ball for Portugal, vai Eder! Chuta!
Hello everyone, here I am today doing Paninkas Europe, or in Portuguese, Europa Paninka. I'm here today with Samuel Valcarcel.
Valcarcel, yes. Well, you l'has dicho bien, well said.
Thank you. He's a fan from Real Sociedad. And he is here today to talk about the match between the Spanish club and Benfica. So, just to start, hello, Samu, how are you? Introduce yourself a little bit and your project, your podcast.
Bueno, first of all, thank you very much. Muito obrigado por estar aquí. I'm going to talk in Spanish because I'm more comfortable. But first of all, thank you for inviting me. Gracias. Soy periodista, soy seguidor de la Real Sociedad y me dedico a cubrir a la Real Sociedad en casa, sobre todo, porque tenemos un pequeño proyecto, como es Ospanenka, pero dedicado solo a la Real Sociedad, en el que hacemos directos en Twitch y cubrimos al equipo a través de Twitter, Instagram, etcétera. Y gracias a ese proyecto que se llama One Club, que en portugués sería algo como un club, personas de un único club, que One Club Men, viene un poco de ahí, pues nos hemos convertido en el canal más conocido de la Real Sociedad y nada, pues una cosa ha llevado a la otra. Nuestro equipo, que es un equipo pequeño, o sea, es grande, es el... entre los grandes el pequeño, entre los pequeños el grande, pues este año volvemos a jugar la Champions y tenemos la oportunidad de venir aquí a Lisboa.
And you have been playing very good matches in Champions League, but we'll get to it.
Sorry, repeat me please the question.
I was just saying that you are playing very good in Champions League.
With a draw against Inter de Milán, empezamos con un empate contra el Inter y sobre todo el partido ante el Salzburgo, the win on Salzburg was amazing. We have never seen anything before like that. Nunca hemos visto una cosa, un partido tan bueno de juego como hizo la Real en Salzburgo. Un Salzburgo que os ganó al Benfica, que ganó al Benfica en Daluz. Quizás condicionado por la roja al Benfica, la tarjeta de Red Card, pero nos sorprendió hasta nosotros lo bien que jugó la Real en Salzburgo y que ahora mismo estemos primeros de grupo.
Sí, yes, it's true. So, the first question, how did you become a Real Sociedad supporter? I think it has something to do where you were born, of course. What can you tell me about the culture, the history, a little bit of the club?
The culture and the history about Real Sociedad, no? Or about
our
city?
Yes, about the club.
I become Real Sociedad supporter, me convertí en aficionado de la Real Sociedad porque es el equipo de mi ciudad, es the team of my hometown. And in San Sebastián, where we are from, we have a lot of identity about our team. It's like no somos de ningún otro equipo que no sea la Real Sociedad. Porque, por ejemplo, en España, como ocurrirá en Portugal, que Benfica, Porto y Sporting de Portugal son los tres clubes más grandes y la mayoría sois de ese equipo. In Spain, is the same. Real Madrid and Barcelona have the most of fans. But in the north of Spain or in the Basque Country, is the land I am from, we are only from our teams. We have near Bilbao, all the people of Bilbao, it's of Athletic Club. It's a very famous team. I think they played in Porto 10 years ago in the Champions League. And in San Sebastian, we have a lot of culture of football and not football, not solo football. La Real Sociedad, La Real, and it's not Sociedad, maybe you have listened about our team, like Sociedad, no? I think the English media call us like Sociedad, and we are not Sociedad, we are La Real.
Real Sociedad.
The whole name is Real Sociedad, but the name we call to our team is La Real. It's like the translation, the literal translation will be the real, but it's La Real. And for us, La Real is more than football. It's our city, our friends, for example, to me, and that's the main question was why I become a Real Sociedad supporter. It's because we feel Real Sociedad like our life, but not like a hooligan who gives his life to his team. It's like Real Sociedad for us, it's our whole life because it's our city, it's our friends, it's our child with our childhood, nuestra infancia. So yo me hice aficionado de la Real Sociedad porque para mí es mi vida, es toda mi vida.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yes, you have talked about that, the difference between, for example, in Portugal, where there are three main clubs. But if we see throughout the country, there are people, for example, living in north that are from Benfica or from Sporting, and people living in south that are from Porto. But I think we also have some of that culture in some places, especially Guimarães. I don't know if you know.
Vitória Guimarães.
Sim, Braga as well.
But, bueno, when 10 years ago when we played the last time the Champions League, I remember Paco de Ferreira played the group stage. They didn't play, but they played the. I don't know how to say in English, la fase previa, the last match. The first stage is before the group stage. I think they play the, and now they are in the second league, no? They are.
Yes, yes, yes.
On the second division.
They are in second division, yes.
Yes.
Yes. And we have more examples, for example, Portimonense, Farense in the south of the country.
This summer I were in Faro. I were in the Estadio do Algarve watching Real Sociedad against Sporting Portugal. They played on the pre-season and the Sporting Portugal win us 3-0, 3-0.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's go to the more tactical and footballistic part. How do you describe the football of La Real?
That's right, thank you. That's a very good question. Es una muy buena pregunta. I will respond in Spanish because my English is not enough to reply this question. El juego de la Real Sociedad es un juego de zurdos, of left players. We have a lot of left players. Un montón de jugadores zurdos de pierna izquierda que marcan mucho el estilo de juego de la Real. ¿Por qué digo esto? El juego de la Real basa mucho su juego en el control del balón, en la posesión, pero no es un juego como el que puede ser, por ejemplo, el del Fútbol Club Barcelona, el que podemos pensar de pases y mantener la pelota. Es una Real Sociedad, no sé si esto se va a entender en portugués, pero camaleónica, se parece mucho a un camaleón, no sé, I think
un
camaleón, it's like a chameleon. Why? Because la Real Sociedad es capaz de adaptarse al equipo al que juega, es capaz de sacrificar el balón igual hacer encerrarse mucho en defensa. No es un equipo defensivo, pero sí capaz de sacar las virtudes, sus virtudes, en momentos donde quizás pues, se pueda enfrentar incluso a rivales, como puede ser el Benfica, que son superiores sobre todo en bandas. Y la Real Sociedad es un equipo que con balón mima mucho y muy bien la pelota, tiene jugadores muy técnicos como son Brais Méndez, Mikel Oyarzabal y sobre todo ahora mismo el hombre de moda está que Kubo, que es el mejor jugador ahora mismo de la plantilla. Pero lo más sorprendente incluso para nosotros, porque nunca lo hemos tenido, es que la Real es un equipo muy físico, o por lo menos más a lo que nos tenemos acostumbrados. Y es un equipo que aguanta físicamente muy bien los 90 minutos de partido, y eso es muy difícil, porque hay muchos equipos que son muy buenos 45 minutos, pero que no son capaces de aguantar el ritmo de un partido. La Real Sociedad, obviamente, tiene mejores minutos o peores, pero es un equipo muy físico y, sobre todo, creo que la seña de identidad que refleja esta Real Sociedad, el titular, ¿no?, de esta Real Sociedad, es que es un equipo que presiona muchísimo, presiona muy alto y nunca deja que su rival salga con el balón tranquilo.
Ok. And you have already talked about a few players, Brais Méndez, Oyarzabal, what can you tell me more of those important players in your team? More about them, more names. How do you think?
More names, hombre. Like,
yes.
We have a Portuguese. We love it, but they didn't play it yet because it's in Europe. It's André Silva. It's probably the best transfer of this summer was André Silva. It's on loan from Red Bull Leipzig, and so we have one of the best strikers in all Europe. 2 years ago, scored like 34 goals in one season, but I don't know. Yet is in Europe, so I think he played like 60 minutes in this season, but more players. The one name, un nombre que no la gente no lo destaca mucho, pero es uno de los más importantes en la Real Sociedad, es el portero. Es goleiro, ¿no? En el portugués es goleiro.
Guarda-redes.
Ah, Guaramets. Alex Remiro. Alex Remiro es posiblemente uno de los mejores porteros de la liga. Tiene el mejor o el segundo mejor juego de pies detrás de Ter Stegen de la Liga Española. Y es muy importante en la Real Sociedad precisamente por eso, porque como la Real juega desde atrás el balón, intenta salir tocándola siempre. Rara vez vas a ver a la Real Sociedad pegando un balón a un pelotazo largo. Alex Remiro es muy, muy importante para eso y creo que es un jugador un poco underdog, un poco infravalorado. Si no, mañana no va a estar, el martes no va a estar Kieran Tierney, que es otro de los fichajes del verano, cedido del Arsenal. Y si me pides dos nombres más para destacar, uno te diría Robin Lenormand, que es central, que ahora está es francés, pero lo ha fichado España, ahora juega con la selección española. Sí. Y el otro, sin ninguna duda, el que para mí es el mejor fichaje de la historia, the best transfer in Real Sociedad history, we made it in 2018 from Newcastle, it was only 8 million euros, and now his value is like 60 million, no, 70 million, Mikel Merino. It's one of the best midfields of Europe, vamos, by far, because it's strong, it's juega muy bien al fútbol, hace muchas faltas, hace muchísimas, muchísimas faltas, pega bastante, pero es el centrocampista perfecto que podría jugar en todos los equipos, yo creo, o en casi todos de la Champions tranquilamente.
Yes, I was looking here at transfer market, and yes, I think the names you have already mentioned. I was just asking for just waiting for Merin, but you left the best as well to the end.
The best always at the end. Yes, I know. If I have to choose three players of Real Sociedad, I will choose always Mikel Oyarzabal, because of his level and the meaning of Real Sociedad is the captain. It's one club man. He refused go to another teams to stay here in Real Sociedad. So for his meaning, I will choose Mikel Oyarzabal. The second one, I will choose Alex Remiro, because I play all my life in the goalkeeper position, so I admire all the goalkeepers. And the third one, of course, Mikel Merino. With those three, to the war, always.
Okay. Now, talking about Benfica a little bit, I wanted to ask you, what do you think about Benfica's style? You have said that La Real has a chameleonic, so it can adapt very well to the other teams. But you have already mentioned that La Real doesn't like to shoot the ball just to the front. You like to sair de trás with the ball. So I was going to ask you, are you afraid that with Benfica's high pressure and gegenpressing, you can lose some balls and, I don't know, suffer a goal or two?
No, because la salida de balón que tiene la Real es tan buena que ha sido capaz de sobrevivir a presiones tan altas que no estoy preocupada, I'm not afraid about the pressure of Benfica. I have a lot of things to be afraid of Daluz, but maybe the pressure of Benfica, it will not the most thing I will be afraid. I will be afraid, for example, of the fans of Benfica. I think Daluz is one of the best stadiums in Europe. We come to Lisboa with a lot of respect. A lot of people, they look to the Champions League, they see Benfica the last, and they say, wow, on Tuesday we will win so easy. And the people who look football, las personas que vemos fútbol, decimos, tranquilidad, Benfica es un equipo muy, muy, muy grande. Muy, muy, muy grande. Y no, o sea, aparte de los jugadores que ahora vamos a hablar, por supuesto, de Di María, David Neres, etcétera, de lo que sí tengo miedo es de la atmósfera que puede generar el estadio de Daluz con un equipo que se está jugando el pase a Champions, porque el Benfica os jugáis la clasificación a Champions League, a octavos de final, os la jugáis en este partido.
Sí, sí.
Eso es lo que a mí me da miedo. Eso es lo que, porque los equipos grandes, y el Benfica es uno de los más grandes, en los momentos difíciles es cuando sacan la cabeza. Y ahí es cuando hay que estar a la altura.
Yes, and that's what I'm expecting from Benfica. For example, just to give you this example, last season we've played against Porto in our league and the Inter Milan. They did one thing to win the game that worked very well. For example, the keeper passed the ball to the attackers, and the attackers win that ball, and then the midfielders win the second ball, and Benfica has a little number of men defending, and so they created a lot of chances. Do you think La Real is going to use that strategy, or not at all? You think you are going to
I think they are going to start playing with the defense, because our style, it's innegotiable. So I don't know, we played against Barcelona, we played against Real Madrid, we played last season against Roma, we played a lot of different big teams, and always we have identity. So I think we will start playing with our defense from when we start the ball with the goalkeeper. And then if the Benfica pressure is a very crazy thing that it's impossible to pass to our defense, pues then, yes, I think that we will start not playing with the striker, so making balls to the other ground, but yes, searching Mikel Merino, Martín Zubimendi. Well, I didn't say anything about Martín Zubimendi. Martín Zubimendi, it's another good player. The midfield of Real Sociedad, it's probably one of the most underdog midfields of all Europe, because, well, it's not the best players, but in 2 years, Zubimendi, probably they will play in Bayern de Munich or a team like that. Mikel Merino can play now in Barcelona, and Brais Méndez, of course, too. But I think, for example, Real Sociedad use a lot the defense of five when he has the ball. So I think they will try it again and again to take the ball from the goalkeeper to the striker, but playing all the players. So I think that Imanol is going to say, Benfica ven, que yo voy a seguir jugando igual.
Okay, and from what I've already seen from Real Sociedad, you have a very unique style with passing, but also turning the game, virar o jogo, virar os flancos, passing the ball to the other side. I don't know if I'm okay. I'm making myself clear. I think you are very good at that with the velocity of Oyarzabal.
No. Oyarzabal have a lot of good things, but speed is not one of them.
Okay. No, I was talking about velocity think the game.
Yes.
Sorry. Yes, but maybe with Kubo and Brais Méndez, you are very little doing that.
I will say that I don't know how to translate in English, but the best meaning to describe how they play is in Spanish: juegan de puntillas, juegan al fútbol with the feet like that, because they play like they will dance in ballet, and they do things very, very speed. For example, you can choose the two goals in Salzburg. You have seen the match, the Salzburg Real Sociedad. Have you seen the two goals?
Yes.
If there is no one, they didn't see it, I recommend you to see, because first of all, there are two beautiful goals, but you can see how fast they think, how fast they do the plays. Maybe, yes, the velocity is not a speed. Sometimes velocity is to think smart and to think well. That's velocity. Yeah. So, yes, bueno, I'm agree with you in that. But no, Oyarzabal is not a speed. I think we have a very technical team, but speed is not one of the things of Oyarzabal.
Okay. So going back to Benfica, you have talked about Di Maria and Neres, but what are the most important players you think, in your opinion, are in Benfica? And if you could bring one or two to La Real, who would you choose?
Well, no, one it's very easy to say, probably because he's one of the most famous names in this time. It's João Neves, no? It's one of
João Neves.
João Neves.
Yes.
Now in Premier League they are asking for him to pay 100 million euros. So I don't know, but honestly I didn't see more like 10 minutes of João Neves. So I will say two players, of course, Ángel Di María. I am 22 years old. When I was 10, Angel Di Maria was God in Real Madrid. I love Di Maria. I remember his celebration doing the heart. But if I will choose one player to Real Sociedad, maybe now he's not living his best moment, but Gonzalo Guedes, it always has been one of them. Of the my favorite players in Valencia was fantastic. 5 years ago, in 2017-2018, did it a spectacular season. And the type of player, it's smart, it's fast, yeah. And I don't know, it's perfect for me. Gonzalo Guedes and well, David Neres. I like the wings. If if you don't, si no lo has visto ya, me encantan los extremos. I like wings. So I will choose first of all Gonzalo Guedes, second Angel Di Maria, but 10 years ago, and probably David Neres, but with that, I don't know. Maybe more. Rafa Silva is a very good midfielder, but we have a lot of good midfielders, so I don't know. Otamendi, maybe to the defense. Yeah, Benfica has a lot of good players. I don't know what choose. Maybe Gonzalo Guedes. Yo elegiría Guedes porque siempre ha sido de mis favoritos.
Okay. And just to end this topic about the match, what do you think is going to be the result, and how do you think the match is going to be?
I will say you, te diría que en San Sebastián la gente está muy optimista, and they think we are going to win, not easy of course, but they are convinced that Real Sociedad is going to win. Me no. 1 month ago, I will tell you that Benfica, they will win this match 3-0, because I think Real Sociedad in these big grounds suffers a lot. But watching Benfica in Champions League maybe is not playing very well. It's like a match ball for Benfica this match. And Real Sociedad arrives to this match playing well, 5th in La Liga, 1st of the group of Champions League. I don't know. My predict is probably a draw, 1-1, but Benfica playing better than Real Sociedad. And if I have to choose one to win, probably I will choose Benfica, because I think Benfica, lo que he dicho, Benfica es un equipo grande, y los equipos grandes en los momentos clave sacan la cabeza. Y el partido del martes es media temporada para el Benfica, así que o empate o Benfica.
Okay. I always ask this question to people who talk with us from other countries and other teams, as you are doing now. But what is the general opinion, in this case in Spain, and your opinion about the Portuguese league and the Portuguese football?
La Liga NOS. No, it's called La Liga NOS.
Liga Bwin.
Ah, Liga Bwin. Bueno, always has been Liga NOS, but well, siempre se ha visto la Liga Portuguesa como. I'm going to try to talk with respect,
But no, you talk whatever you want.
Honestly, I'm going to talk how we see this, the Portuguese league from Spain with honesty. Con honestidad, la Liga Portuguesa se ve como una liga menor respecto a las demás ligas. Primero porque realmente en España, para el que siga el fútbol más o menos, conoce a Benfica, conoce a Sporting de Portugal, conoce a Oporto, pero ya a partir del Braga ya no le preguntes a nadie más por... O sea, creo que en España muchos, no te diría 10 equipos de la Liga NOS, y yo te los digo así, porque te digo, porque el Pacos de Ferreira jugaba la Champions hace 10 años, Farense, pues Vitória Guimarães, Braga, Oporto, Sporting, Benfica, pero me empiezas a quitar de ahí y ya empiezo a sufrir un poco más de equipos en Portugal. Entonces, si ya no te quedo de los equipos, es un síntoma de que quizás la liga portuguesa no es muy conocida. Tampoco se le insulta como la liga francesa. To the French League, Spanish people, they call it that it's a Farmers League. To Liga Bewin, maybe the thought is probably similar. But, for example, I'm talking generally about the Portuguese football. But, talking specifically about Benfica, Sporting Lisboa and Oporto, the thing changes because, for example, me, I remember the Europa League final in 2011.
Yes, in 12 as well.
In 12? No.
2013.
Was in Dublin, the Oporto against Benfica was, no? Oporto-Benfica.
No, Porto Braga.
Ah, Porto Braga was the final. I didn't remember it was Braga in the final. So I remember the Falcao's goal.
I think it was 2010.
Portugal playing against Athletic Club the semi-finals the next year. I remember the 2003 champions of UEFA Porto and 2004 champions of Champions League with Mourinho. But como el Benfica, ni el Sporting Lisboa, ni el Porto en Europa tienen tan buen papel, sobre todo en los últimos años, y como en España tenemos un equipo como el Real Madrid y otro como el Barcelona, que ganan todo, absolutamente todo en Liga, en Europa y tal, pues se ve el fútbol portugués como un fútbol menor y básicamente como un fútbol donde poder fichar a las estrellas y poco más.
Ok. Obrigado, Samu. Thank you very much for being here. And let's see, let's hope for a good game. And in my perspective, let Benfica win.
Oh, I hope they Real Sociedad win. But for me, it's a pleasure to visit Lisboa, to visit Benfica. It's a team that I have a lot of respect. And probably I like more than Sporting Portugal and Porto. So I like, for example, how the El Águila separa. Bueno, no sé, en Champions hacéis lo del Águila. En Champions League el Águila baja y se posa en el brazo del ahí en el estadio. No, no sé si me estás. Do you understand me? What I don't know if you understand me.
No, I'm sorry. The Wi-Fi connection wasn't very very.
Do you listen me right now?
Not very well. Can you repeat?
Preguntaba por el águila. Si todavía en Benfica, en Daluz, hacéis lo del águila que se pone en el brazo del.
Águila, the hawk.
Yes, Agui. The hawk.
Okay.
I am asking you. If you do it in all the matches, the hawk in the
yes.
So that's amazing. So for me, it's going to be an experience to cover a match in Daluz. So it's a spectacular stadium. The stadium when they played the Euro Cup final in 2004 when Portugal lost against Greece. But I am very huge fan of football, and Daluz is one of the temples of football. So only with the experience is enough. But I hope that Real Sociedad win the match, and with a draw I'm happy because Real Sociedad consigue un empate y nos vemos en la vuelta.
Yes. So I aproveito para desejar un buen juego. Agora em português.
Um bom jogo, pero tu firmas um empate. You can firm now a draw for us and everybody happy.
No, I don't know because I don't think it's going to be enough to pass the group. But I think I would sign a draw in your stadium, but in Luz, I think we have to get a victory, a win.
So, pues I frame on Tuesday, Real Sociedad win, and in Anoeta, we draw. For me, it's perfect.
Okay, thank you, Samuel, again for being here.
Pleasure is mine. Obrigado por vuestra invitación. Forza Benfica, Forza Benfica. Muita sorte.
Obrigado, igualmente. And to all our listeners, thank you. Também. A big hug and see you last week.
Passa a bola para Portugal, vai Éder, chuta!